Quantum entanglement is the status of two subatomic particles which are somehow correlated with each other.
The entangled particles' spin properties are depending on each other. Both are always having opposite directions. If we change one of the entangled particles' spin orientation by measuring it, then the another particle's spin orientation is changed automatically to opposite to the first one. The change happens instantaneously. Two photons are getting entangled sometime. Entangled photon can be created by one of the famous method called spontaneous parametric down conversion. The ultraviolet laser beam is shined into a beta barium borate crystal. Sometime, one photon is splitted into two photons and deflecting into different directions. These two photons are in entangled state. If we arrange the BBO crystal in particular way, the created two photons polarizations will be always opposite to each other. By measuring the polarization of one photon, we can find the other's polarization immediately without measuring it. Okay, so far, so good. But what is the special thing here? When two photons are entangled, then neither has its own polarization state. Both are in superposition state. That means these polarizations are in all directions simultaneously. Both photons get definite polarization only when either particle get measured and turned into opposite direction to each other. Photons are passing through BBO crystal. Sometime, one of the photons splitted into two photons and getting entangled. So, these are in superposition now. While measuring one photon, we found that is vertical. Then other become horizontal. It is happening even if we move one of the particle to opposite side of the world, or even to another planet. It is communicating faster than speed of light. This is what bothered Albert Einstein a lot, because his relativity theory tells that nothing can travel faster than speed of light. Albert Einstein was believing that the polarizations have been determined at the time itself when they were created, and the particles have definite state all the time. It looks Einstein was right. We cannot see superposition state. It is not visible. If we measure it, then it comes into definite state. How can we believe this? See this demo. We have a pair of boxes and gloves. Put each gloves into separate boxes without looking it. Send one of the box to Bob, who is in America, and another box to Alice, who is in Japan. Gloves are separated and sent to different destinations, but not yet reached. Alice in Japan prefers right-hand glove to receive. Gloves are already separated. Is it making any sense to she prays to God to receive right-hand gloves in this box? Actually, no. The glove is already determined to her while separating the pair. Bob opens the box and knows that the glove is right hand. Then immediately he can know that the box in Japan has left hand glove. Alice opens the box and confirms that the glove is left hand. Nothing is special here. Bob cannot be proud himself to find this. So, the entanglement business is also similar kind. Then what is the strange thing here? But if we looking into careful manner, we can see the difference between gloves and particles' behaviors. Assume the same two gloves are in another strange world created by the God with different behavior. God and the team are in the progress of creating new world. they are running out of the resources, encountering resource deficit in creating creature sense and object stabilization. God decided to make creatures blind, and objects are not stable until someone to touch it. If there are multiple dependent objects, then choosing the object state randomly. In this world, Alice can pray to God to get the right hand glove even after the gloves were separated and dispatched. This is what happening in quantum entanglement. Albert Einstein was telling that there is no action at distance. And Niels Bohr was telling that entanglement remote action is true. Their debate was going for a long time. After 30 years in 1927, John Bell had proven mathematically that entanglement is true. The concept of Bell's inequality is very famous. I am trying to prove it by very simple logic. Listen carefully. Something really very amazing thing is in the work. Alice in the Earth has 2000 photons which are not entangled state. She sent half of them to Bob who is in Mars. Now both are having 1000 photons. The goal is that Alice has to measure her photon one by one and tell Bob the direction which allowed to pass for sure. Alice starts measuring her photons now. She thought the both side photons are always opposite. So she has decided to ask Bob to use opposite to her photon passing direction. Remember, these photons are not entangled. She first tries with vertical filter and found passed. So she sent message to Bob to use horizontal filter. Bob then uses horizontal filter and found passed. Second time, Alice uses the same vertical filter and found blocked. So she sent message to Bob to use vertical filter. Bob uses vertical filter and found his photon also blocked. So failure. Third time success. Fourth time failure. Fifth time failure. Sixth time failure. Seventh time success. And so on. At end of the test, they got 42% of success rate. Then Alice has planned a different idea. She creates 1000 entangled pair of photons and separate each pair and send each one of 1000 pair to Bob. Now both are having 1000 photons. Remember, Alice and Bob's photons are now entangled. First time, she tries with vertical filter and found passed. So she sent message to Bob to use horizontal filter. Bob then uses horizontal filter and found passed. Second time, Alice uses the same vertical filter and found blocked. So she sent message to Bob to use vertical filter. Bob then uses vertical filter and found passed. So the result is success. Third time success, fourth time success, fifth time success, sixth time success, seventh time success, and so on. At end of the test, they found 100% success rate. As per Albert Einstein's opinion, this is not wonder because both were already in opposite directions when Alice created. So she could easily find Bob's photon state by simply looking her photons. But that's not true. Assume both were already determined and opposite directions. That means if A is 0 degree, then B should be 90 degree. If A is 45, then B should be 135. Suppose A is 45 degree. What should be B? B should be 135 degree, right? Now, these are the scenarios as per Albert Einstein's view. Alice has photon 45 degree polarized. Bob has photon 135 degree polarized. Both photons are entangled state. The polarization states are predetermined. Both Alice and Bob don't know what is the polarization state of their photons. And there will not be any action at distance while measuring one photon. Now, Alice measures it by vertical filter. The angle between the filter and photon is 45 degrees. What would be the result? We cannot tell exactly, right? Because this is pure probability. We have already seen that 45 degree with vertical filter has 50% chance to pass and 50% chance to get blocked. Assume it is passed. So now the photon at Alice side has new polarization state of 0 degree. Previously it was 45, now it is 0. Now Alice side is 0 degree and Bob side is still 135 degree. Now Alice has to tell Bob to use horizontal filter, because she found vertical filter passes her photon. So the same vertical filter will block Bob's photon. So Bob has to use horizontal filter, then only his photon will pass. Alice send message to Bob to use horizontal filter, and Bob is trying the same. He tries 90 degree filter with 135 degree photon. Will his photon pass for sure? No, it may or may not pass, because the angle between photon and filter is 45 degree. It will pass 50% of the time and will block another 50% of the time. But our test results are something different. We are always getting 100% success result while measuring with the exact opposite direction. When would 100% success be possible? That's only when Bob's photon get changed according to Alice's photon get changed while measuring it. So the action at the distance is true. Albert Einstein's declaration is wrong. Really, entangled particles are communicating faster than the speed of light.